glad you're here with us this morning. And we'd like you to join us on our very first sing-along song. So please arise and join the team of Wolfridges and Dales and Allens up here with a Karen Drucker song called I'm So Grateful.
And there's a hand movement. Grateful for. I'm grateful that the fires are out. Yeah. And for the thousands of men and women that fought those fires and kept us safe. And I just want to send my love to all the wildlife that perished in the fire, because there was nothing we could do about that. So I think about that first thing this morning, that's what I thought about. So I'm grateful to be here, and I'm grateful you're here this morning. We are a center that welcomes all people. Wherever you are on your spiritual path, you are welcome here and welcome home. So we start the service with the Flames of Faith. We perform this ceremony to promote the universal consciousness of life, which acknowledges that all peoples and all faiths, all sentient beings come from the one great universal presence that we call spirit. Fundamental to this truth is the unifying nature of all religious thought and experience, which we honor here today. We light the candle for the Tao, honoring the universal path of harmony and equilibrium. the natural way. We light the candle for the shamanic traditions, honoring the beliefs and the practices of all indigenous peoples, the way of primal spirituality. We light the candle for Hinduism, honoring the path of knowledge, action, and devotion. We light the candle for Judaism, honoring the ethical path of living by sacred law. We light the candle for all forms of Buddhism, honoring the Four Noble Truths and the path of compassion. We light the candle for all forms of Christianity, honoring the Christ consciousness as the path of love. We light the candle for all forms of Islam, honoring the path of compliance with the will of God as the highest calling. We light the candle for the universalistic religion of Baha'i, honoring the path of unity and the path of peace. We light the candle for all forms of new thought, honoring the metaphysical path of mental healing through the practice of universal spiritual principles. And as practitioner Dave Freeman lights the last candle, let it represent the path that brought you here this morning. Please join me in the serenity of prayer. We join together in that united field of pure loving God consciousness, knowing and recognizing that there truly is only one divine presence, one awesome magnificence, one life, one unconditional love. And this energy, this spirit, this God is the first cause to all of creation. For we know what we think about, we bring it about in our experience. So I know that each one of us has all these qualities, the love, the compassion, the kindness, the acceptance. We all these qualities live within each one of us. For we truly are the voice and the thoughts and the actions of spirit. We are the love. We are the sacred activity of God. So this morning I affirm and I decree that all is well, that each one of us is here this morning to awaken to our divine nature, to who we truly are, which is spirit in action. I know that this service unfolds in absolutely perfect order, and that Dr. Heather's message inspires us with her wisdom, brings us to a place of higher consciousness, of acceptance, of joy. For we truly are alive, awake, and aware this morning, knowing the truth of who we are. So I place my words into divine mind where they've already been created, just as I believe. And I say thank you with deep gratitude for this beautiful center, for this service, and for this knowing. So I anchor this prayer in confidence, in love, and in joy. And together we say, and so it is. I'd like to invite Patrick Freeman up to do our affirmation and declaration of principles.
Thank you, Reverend Judy. Look at what's on the screen. I believe in God,
the one creative intelligence, operating through the universe and operating throughout my entire being, now and always.
I believe this perfect spirit operates upon a law of mind and creates my experience exactly according to my belief. I believe this perfect creative intelligence can be used by me and by every other person to produce health, abundance, and love in mind, body, and total life experience. I use it now, and I rejoice in it, and so it is. And the affirmation for today. Nothing is broken, so I count my blessings. I count the beauty of the earth. I count my breaths and the moments to take my breath away. I count all my friends and family. My blessings are too numerous to be counted. And so it is.
Thank you, Patrick, and please welcome Allendale. Yay! Our sister, our spiritual sister, Janet Cook, introduced us to this song. It's by a country rock duo called Jamestown Revival. And in the meantime, I have just fallen in love with their heart, with their authenticity and their harmonies and their music. And so today we're gonna do one of their songs called This Too Shall Pass.
Trust me when I say this too.
Turning them on to this, I guess, duo. I don't know if she turned you on to that. Anyway, thank you, everybody. I'm so happy to see everybody today. My message this morning is count your blessings. The whole month is about remembering to feel the gratitude that is indwelling us and for all of the good that indwells us and surrounds us. And I just wanted to give you an update on the cats before I forget, because something wonderful occurred this week, and you all told me it would, because I said they hide and then they're so shy and they're only friendly when they're hungry. Well, now something happened this last week. I changed their litter and there's pheromones in the litter, and the first time they stepped in the litter, they did a little dance. They danced, actually got in and out, like, oh, what's happening? This is a good place. And then, now a week later, they're going in, if it's clean, and they just sit there. They're not doing anything, just they like it. And then they come and hang up with me and purr and purr and purr and purr. It's been absolutely heavenly. So, one of my blessings I'm counting is that you wouldn't let me get away with that negative stuff, that they're going to always be unfriendly. They're not being unfriendly, they're being very friendly and also very trusting, which I'm so grateful for. So the whole idea about gratitude and blessing, the idea about blessing is that this is something that we do. We do to each other, we do for each other, but mostly we do for ourselves. Because as you know, and I've spoken about this often, it's proven that how we're feeling affects our bodies. If we're feeling really great, those positive things, Michael Beckwith calls them the tonic chemicals, the tonic comes in, lifts us up, makes us happy and more productive, etc. If we've been thinking negative thoughts, they're actually toxic. They're actually toxic to our bodies, to the body temple, to our lives. So if we're thinking negativity, fear, blame, regret, any of those things, we're actually poisoning ourselves. So this is a wonderful day to make a decision to stop that. The only one that has any control of what goes on in your mind is you. Just like the only one that has any control of what goes on in my own mind is me. And I know that many of us have such a habit of rehearsing the worst case scenario, a real habit of it. So if something happens and out of the blue, we're back there in that fear place of then this is going to happen. And then we take that energy, we learn to take that energy and go to the best case scenario. What's the best thing that could happen right now? Well, I've already told you with my cats, that was the best thing, it's continuing to happen. What's the best thing in your lives that could happen right now? Learn to rehearse that, learn to put your energy there about those relationships that make your heart sing. About the money that keeps flowing in, and there seems to be so much more of it than there ever has been before. About your friendships, about your healthy body and the energy you have and the flexibility you have and how much power and strength you have. The best case scenario. Practice, practice, practice. Rehearse that until it becomes so easy for you to go there consciously. When you find yourself slipping to that other place, take a breath. Go to the best case scenario, because it could be that good. It could be, and what we rehearse actually becomes what we're experiencing. I'm going to tell you a couple of stories from one of the books I've had for a long time and I'd forgotten about it. It's written by Naomi Rachel Remen. And this one, she's written a couple of other books that are very well known too, but this one's called My Grandfather's Blessings. I highly, highly, highly recommend this book. She is a wonderful writer. She's a physician. And so many of her stories are autobiographical because she has an interesting life. And she was raised by her parents, and all of her uncles and aunts were highly intellectual and very not spiritual. But her grandfather was mystical. And he brought to her the idea of blessing. And she said she could look around her place and even today see gifts that he gave her. And he died when she was 7. That the gifts that he gave were meaningful. And one of the most interesting ones was he came one day when she was 4, I think, with a cup that was filled with dirt. And she wasn't allowed to play with dirt. So she said, "Grandfather, what is this?" He said, he went to her playroom and got a little play teapot for her dollies. And he said, "Every day, put a little water in the cup." No explanation, nothing. "Every day, put a little water in the cup, and you'll be so happy you did." So, for the first week, every day, right at the same time, she'd get her little teapot ready, she'd put water in the cup, and nothing happened. And then the second week, she tried to give it back to her grandfather. "There's nothing happening. Would you like this cup back?" "No, keep putting just a little bit of water in the cup." And so by the third week, she was getting really annoyed because there's nothing happening, and she's putting water in this cup every day. But she would some days forget until she was already in bed, but she remembered that she had promised her grandfather that every day she'd put a little water in this cup. So she'd get up out of bed and go to the playroom, get her little teapot and water this cup. Sometime in that fourth week, she noticed there were 2 leaves. And she was so excited. "There are 2 leaves in my cup. It's not just dirt. There's something in there." And they grew. And they grew, and they grew. And so she could hardly wait to talk to her grandfather about this miracle. And he said, "That's what happens in life. If you look for the good, you will find it everywhere. Life itself is brimming with good, but we just don't see it." She said, "Oh, grandfather, do all I have to do is put water in?" And he said, "No, it isn't about the water. It's about your faithfulness. It's about your faithfulness. How faithfully she kept her word. How much every single day, even though she couldn't see results, she put water in that cup." I think that's something for all of us to remember. And that when we're doing that, when we're being faithful in our spiritual practices, in our exercise program, in our commitment to being friendly to people, to seeing the good and praising it, when we're being faithful, the world around us changes. It gets better because we have perceived something differently. So counting your blessings is about learning to perceive everything as good. Everything, no exceptions. I hate it when I say that. But it happens to be a word of truth. No exceptions. It's everything responds to the same idea. Everything. That life is constantly moving through us, and life is good. The thing I call God, it doesn't matter what you call it. It's that divine spark that is everywhere. Many of you know, because we do this, that here, when we say namaste, what it really means is the God in me greets and acknowledges the God in you. And it's a blessing. Let's say that again. Namaste. The God in me greets the God in you. Oh, I forgot part of it. The God in me greets and salutes the God in you. So, or you could just say namaste means that there's a spark of divinity within the person I'm looking at. And that's true whether you were looking at another person or whether you were looking in the mirror. There's a spark of divinity. And sometimes we forget that it includes us. We can't bless unless we have first been blessed by ourselves, until we have accepted those blessings. There's another book that, if you've already read The Good News for the Month, Julie Isola featured it in The Good News, which is, by the way, you get it in your email, and it's well worth reading because it tells you everything that's going to happen in the month, and also some really good writing because she always does the feature article. It's wonderful. And she wrote about the book for the month is The Gentle Art of Blessing. The Gentle Art of Blessing by Pierre van der Waal, I think. I might have to look up his last name. But anyway, The Gentle Art of Blessing, if you want to look it up. I got it on my Kindle a year ago, and then I forgot that I had it. It was so nice to look at my Kindle. Oh, I've already got this book. And he starts out, this writer starts out by saying that he proved how powerful blessing was. And it started because of something that he would say was not a blessing. He was in a job, he was an educator working with both teachers and students. And he was in a position in this job that there were people around him that, if he continued in a certain way, it would be against his own ethics. You all know what I'm talking about. That sometimes what you're called to do, maybe in a job or maybe in a relationship, friendship, is not right for you. Not right for you. So this thing, he said, it came down to either I had to quit my job or make a huge change and be unethical. He decided to quit his job. But then, you can imagine, no money, no job. He was filled with resentment and rage and anger at these other people that had forced him into quitting his job. And he realized, and he remembered a passage from the Bible that that was saying you have to forgive your enemies and bless those who have cursed you. Bless those. So I thought, well, what have I got to lose? So he started a practice of blessing out loud in his home all of these people that had caused him, that I guess they were doing something that he considered unethical. He doesn't spell that out in the book, but something. But he blessed them one by one, and what he did. So blessing is to confer prosperity. He would say something like, I bless you, Joe. I bless you so that you are more prosperous than you have ever been. I bless you so that you're marriage is happy. I bless you so that your health is, I mean, everything that could be blessed about a person, he went through it one by one by one by one, again and again and again, and he noticed something started to change in himself. He started to feel lighter and happier, and he was not spending any time in this place of resentment anymore. So we know his body felt better too. He was more vitally alive, fully conscious, and he said that over the next few years, he demonstrated to himself how powerful it was to bless people who had harmed people, or people that who had harmed you, or people that he might have an issue with. He tells a story about he got into doing not-for-profit work and helping raise money for these nonprofits, and one of them was putting on a big musical event, and there were 20 pieces in the orchestra plus vocalists. And for some reason, the sound tech was not in favor of this program. And he pulled all of the equipment except for two microphones off the stage. And so meanwhile, the one guy, his partner, Pierre's partner, was busy arguing with this sound tech about they really needed more than that, and he was silently blessing the person. He said it took him about 2 hours, and there was a complete shift in consciousness, a complete change of attitude. Instead of saying, no, we can't, you don't need any more, all of a sudden he said, oh, I know where there are 12 more microphones. He went, got them out, started to set up the complete shift. What happened? Something on the invisible side of life spoke to that person that was against this project and allowed him to get on board. It was that blessing. He was blessing this man who was being so difficult to deal with. Now, what's that got to do with us today? Everything. Absolutely everything. If there's anyone, the person that you know, person that you don't know, person that's in the news a lot, a person that you see in the newspaper a lot, a person that for some reason just seems to annoy you. This is the time to start blessing that person. Silently in your own home or out loud in your own home, confer prosperity on this one. I can hear some of the wheels going, well, I don't want him to be prosperous. It's not about that, it's about you. It's about changing your mind so that life can move fully into every situation. You know, we say about this power, God, that it's good and that it's for everything. It doesn't have a negative switch that says, now I'm against. It's not about being against anything, it's about being for life, for the well-being, for health, for happiness, for joy, for dancing to the pheromones or dancing to the endorphins, but for dancing, for moving through as blessing. So the last point I want to make. When you look in your mirror, what do you see? When you look deeply into your own eyes, do you see that spark of divinity that is namaste? Do you see this greatness that you are? Because you are. There is nothing that you've ever done. See, this is the thing. Many of us were taught about a judgmental God. That thing doesn't exist. It's never existed. There's only been this wonderful, wonderful, ongoing love. That's all. This wonderful presence of power. So back to looking in your own eyes. The one to confer prosperity on, first and foremost, is you. Louise Hay, her very famous work is to look into the mirror and tell yourself that I love you, you're special, you're beautiful. If you can't say that, that's fine. I love you. It's about when we convey prosperity, we've forgiven everything that's unlike that prosperity. So I'll talk about it more another Sunday, but it's ho'oponopono you. So that blessing of Len Hu, which is, I'm sorry, please forgive me. Thank you, I love you. In your own mirror, I'm sorry, please forgive me. Thank you, I love you. When I count my blessings, the very first and biggest one is being able to do this work. Having you come on, many of you come Sunday after Sunday after Sunday, and it fills my heart with gratitude. And many of you come the next week and say, I've been doing what you said, and my life is better. And that fills my heart with great joy. You are the blessing, and what is it? When I count my blessings, I count you twice. And that's the truth, and so it is. We're going to pray together, because that's what we do around here. So in this holy moment of right now, and I'm going to speak this word in the first person, take what fits for you and what doesn't fit, just let it flow over you like water, or like pass by like a breeze. This is what I know. I know that there's a power and presence that I call God, that it is good and it is everywhere present. It is all-knowing, it is divine love, it is the joy of expression. Everywhere, everywhere, everywhere. I know that this one that is the first cause of all creation, that is creator and created, is forever expressing through all of its creation. It is the beginning and the end and everything in between. All. It is all. Knowing that that's so, even my busy brain can't figure out a way to separate myself from it. It is right where I am. It is in me, for me, around me, as me. I speak this word for myself in the first person, and this is what I know. I bless myself by being a blessing. I bless myself by telling myself the truth of life, the truth that I matter, that my consciousness matters. I tell myself that joy is important and that it is easy and natural and effortless. I tell myself that good is another word for God, and God is good in me and in all others. I speak this word for relationships that are meaningful, for friendships that are deep and profound and caring. I speak this word for health that is vital and holy and whole and wholesome, that the vitality of life itself flows through every cell, every tissue, every function, every fiber of my being, of the body temple, of the I am that I am. I speak this word for creativity and for the experience of that creative process. Divine ideas, new ideas, great ideas are coming to me right now. I love it. I am grateful for it. I accept it. I make welcome and make available myself to these great ideas. I am open and receptive to more prosperity of every good kind in my life. It is a flow of energy that is positive and wholesome and holy. I am so grateful for knowing this. I speak this word for anyone, any part of me that is heartbroken, that is sad, that is concerned. I speak this word that there is a healing going on. That one power that is all-knowing is compassion itself and is lifting me up. I'm so very grateful. And with my heart overflowing with joy, for life is good, I simply place this word in the law of God. I accept that it's already so, it's already done, and please help me by saying,
and so it is.
And Dale. And the Wolfridges.
It's time for us to share our gifts, our tithes, our offerings. If the stewards would please come forward. And how we do this, we read our prosperity affirmation together, and then we take a few seconds of silent gratitude just to multiply and bless all the good that is already in our lives, or just to be thankful for the people and places, etc. So, and then that'll be followed up by us singing. It's a new song now. Gratitude. I asked for this one. I send my love. And then an instrumental that Diane is going to gift us with. All right. So, please join me. My offering is my acceptance of God as the source of my supply and symbolizes my faith in the abundant flow of this supply. Thank you. you are in service today or have been in service this week, would you please stand so we can give you a lot of love? Thank you, Mrs. Pinky, for being a difference. So grateful for you and all that you do. Practitioners remain standing. The practitioners are trained in the art and science of affirmative prayer. If you want your life transformed, make an appointment with one of these people. You'll be so happy that you did, because your life will be completely changed. You want a taste of it on Sunday morning? The affirmative prayer tables at the back and or the tranquility room will house one of these wonderful people. And in service today, we have Cheryl Lyman, Patrick Freeman, and Dave Friedman. So let's acknowledge our practitioners. And also, if you're here for the very first time, and my guests, you don't have to be embarrassed. You can stand if you want, or you can not, but you're going to receive a gift. So indicate that that's you somehow. Anyone here for the first time? In front of you, Joni. Joni, in front of you also, right here, these two ladies. One of them had their hands up. What we're going to do, so we're so grateful that you came to visit us this morning, and we're going to affirm you, and inside your, inside the little bag of goodies, you'll find a welcome card. If you fill it out and take it to the bookstore, you'll receive another gift. It's a book. And so for all of our visitors this morning, rest of the congregation, please repeat after me. Something wonderful is happening this morning.
Something wonderful is happening this morning.
It's happening because you are here.
It's happening because you are here.
You are valued and valuable.
You are valued and valuable.
You make a difference.
You make a difference.
And so it is.
And so it is.
So welcome, 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 everyone. And then it's the first of the month. So, you know, God's greatest gift, greatest idea is you. If you have a November birthday, please stand.
Our time to share food together, laugh together, and get to know each other better in a friendly atmosphere.
And then at noon, join Conscious Connection right here in the sanctuary for a brief discussion about today's topic.
This week at Wednesday's Wisdom, Lee Van Slyke will present Let's Clean Up Our Spiritual Desktop. Sounds like great advice. It starts at 7 p.m.
Be here. And for those of you creatives who make things that you'd like to sell at our holiday boutique, there is a sign-up sheet on the kiosk that is going to be held on December 8th after the service. So if you have any questions, see me.
Classes? We are not a classless society here. On Sundays at 12:30, Aidan Greeney is teaching the Science of Mind 101 class on the spiritual path. This is an 8-week session and is ideal for both new students and anyone who would like to review the basics. See Aidan if you have questions or want to sign up.
And on Tuesday evenings at 6:30, Dr. Heather is teaching the Practitioner 1 class, and there are prerequisites for this class for enrollment. So if you want to join, talk to Dr. Heather, please.
And just a quick reminder that our friendship circles are still open for enrollment, so sign up.
And there's always so much going on here. So, I mean, we have our Shifting Stands group, our One Spirit men's group, our women's circle, Coming Home, Awakening to Spirit, and the Circle of Love. So take those inserts home with you and look them over. And now, the children.